gone are those days when a man was the only breadwinner of the family. Gone are those days when the man was the only one looked up to provide everything for the family, both breakfast, lunch and supper. In this jet age today, the woman also stands firm. The woman also stands solid in order to provide for the family. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for joining us on today's edition of All About Her. Today we are talking about the woman being the breadwinner of the family. What problems does it cause? What are some of the challenges a family with a woman who is the one providing goes through every now and then? Some men find it kind of degrading on their status, and some families rather find it a blessing, for a woman can always work and provide for her family. That's what we're going to have on the menu today on All About Her. It's always a pleasure having you both to join us. And today, before we start, I would like to announce my guest already. It's none other person but Madame Kwande Mary. She is a retired nurse. She's worked for ages here in the Bafoussam Regional Hospital. She's married. She has children, and then she has a home. She understands what it means to provide for the family. Good afternoon, Madame Kwande Mary.
Good afternoon, my daughter.
Thank you very much. I'm fine, thank you. What about you?
Fine.
You're welcome on board All About Her.
Thank you.
It's always a pleasure having you, though it's the first time. I feel like I've had you for so many times.
Thank you very much.
I'm pleased to have you.
Really.
How are you doing today?
Doing fine.
Okay, I just want you to understand the fact that we're in a world where things have changed, and then it's not all about the man. It's not all about the man providing, and the woman also provides. That's why I decided that I'm going to get somebody with whom we can talk about a woman being the breadwinner of the family. What problem does it pose? Is it a blessing or is it a curse, in quotes, as some people will find it? So what do you think generally about a woman being the sole provider of the family? What do you think generally about that?
A woman being a sole provider of the family is a good thing. It's a blessing, depending on how the person takes it, the spouse takes it.
Okay.
There are spouses who don't take it good. Mm-hmm. Other spouses take it good.
Mm-hmm.
So, from creation, you see that God created man. Created man, he saw that it was not all he had to create. He made the man to go down into a deep sleep. And when the man went to sleep, he removed the rib of the man to form the woman. So the woman is part of the man. So when a woman gets to a certain age, she has to get married. When she's married, she's part and parcel of the man. But all said and done, there are times when the woman, I want to come back to our topic here. When the woman...
I want you to set the pace so that we can get our motivational quote from the day, for the day.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay. When a woman is the breadwinner of the family, it depends on the families. They are families that are built on a solid rock. Being the solid rock is that the family that is built of Jesus Christ.
Definitely.
And a family that is just like that.
No solid foundation.
It's just like you built your house on the sun and the wind came.
And it sang away and everything. So that's it. Madame Kwande Mary has told us about two families. A woman can be a breadwinner of a family with no problem if that family is built on the solid rock. And the solid rock and the solid foundation is no other person but Jesus Christ. And then it poses a problem now where the family is not built on a perfect foundation. That's what brings us to our motivational quote of the day, dear viewers, and it goes thus. The perfect woman you see is a working woman, not an idler, not a fine lady, but one who uses her hands and her head and her heart for the good of others and for the good of her family. I read again. The perfect woman you see is a working woman, not an idler, not a fine lady, but one who uses her hands, her head and her heart for the good of others and the good of her family. That's our motivational quote for the day, and I hope it touched somebody somewhere. I hope it touched a lady somewhere. I hope it touched a woman somewhere. But before talking about a woman somewhere, I want to come to you, Madam Mary. I want to ask you, what's your description of a perfect woman? The motivational quote says, a perfect woman is not all about having a fine face, having everything, but it's about being able to use your head, to use your heart in order to help others and also help your family. And I think a woman who helps her family is a breadwinner. So to you, what is the image of a perfect woman, or a definition of a perfect woman?
A perfect woman is no woman apart from that woman of Proverbs 31 that you just described.
Okay.
He's that woman who will take care of her home. She's that woman who will make sure her husband is upright.
Okay.
She's that woman who will make sure that the children have something to eat. She's that woman who is always there caring for the family. I think that's what I can say.
Wow, a woman who is always there for her children, for her family. Mm-hmm. A woman who uses her hands for the benefit of her family.
Yes.
That is the case today. I think that's the thing every woman nowadays is struggling to do.
Yes.
Every woman nowadays wants to do something, wants to chip in something into the family. They don't just want to sit out there and watch the man do the thing. Like I started, gone are those days.
Yes.
When the man was the sole breadwinner of the
Yes.
family.
Mm-hmm.
But now you now discover that in cases where the woman is the sole breadwinner of the family, there are some hitches that come into the family, like a woman who is providing already. So main thing that once a woman start providing, they start disrespecting their husbands. I want to see if you buy that idea. Instances where women who provide rather kind of start looking down on their husbands. That's a particular point. It's a topic that is very fertile and tends to make the family shaky or something. What do you think about that?
Yes, buy that. Not totally, partially.
Okay.
Partially, because there are families that, as I earlier said, when they are built on a solid rock, even though there are some problems, but it's not all that well. There is a problem, they will go down, pray to God, and everything will be fine. But there are families that, when they are not built on that solid rock, my sister telling you, my daughter. When, let's take for example, a man who was a director of the company, suddenly he lost his job. You see, the woman, now she is the one providing. The woman would develop
wings.
She'll develop wings. Say, okay, I'm the man of the house. I can do this, I can do that. Then she will start behaving a type, forgetting that the man was the one providing yesterday. Normally, in that case, when it's like that, you will see pride coming in, which is not good.
It's not good. So I don't know. Does it mean that money is really that bad? Money really has that effect. Let me call it money, because breadwinning is about providing financially for the family.
Yes.
Like before, you see a woman, she was calm. She was respectful to her husband and everything was fine. But at that moment where she began to provide for the family, things changed. I don't know if it's the burden of provision on their shoulder that makes them change. I don't really understand. At some point, what is it that really makes these women change? Is it the fact that it's the money, or is the fact that the burden is so much for them to shoulder?
Money is not bad. It depends on the motive. How you want to use the money. Money is what keeps us going. But the point is that don't let money control you. Don't allow money to control you. But you should control money. Because if you start developing things, it means that now the money has come. You just want to show that you are big, you are this, you are that. Meanwhile, in a home, the woman is supposed to respect the husband. As the Bible says, the duty of the woman is to be submissive to the man.
Even if she is the one providing, she
even
ought to
if
be
she
submissive.
Is the one providing, she ought to be submissive. She does not have to develop wings, be it one, because she has none. Never. God in creation, if man is the head of the family. Even if you, the woman, you are the president of this country, you will not be the head of the man. You have to be. You do your duty where you are supposed to do your duty, then you come back. The submissiveness remains in the home.
Definitely, the submissiveness, it has to remain. But then, looking at the fact that the same Bible says, yes, the man is the kind of the head of the family, does it not also mean that the man is supposed to provide? At some points, maybe it's not in every case that the man kind of doesn't have his job already, that the woman tends to provide. Some men are naturally lazy and they let their women provide. What do you have to say about that? In that situation, in that case where it's the man who is naturally lazy and the woman, out of love, out of compassion, decides to provide for the home, and some men are so ungrateful that even when you are providing, they don't appreciate it.
Really, it's true. Men are what they are. You will see some men really, even be it what, you do what in a home, they will never say thank you. It's their own pride. They want to keep it. And one point that I want to put my hand on is this. It's every woman who knows his man. Every woman. You know, no two men can be the same. My husband will hardly say to me, thank you. But he will go and buy something and give me. I know that he's thanking me. You see. Another person's husband will say, well, dear, I'm sorry. This is, another one will not say like that. But it's good that every woman takes his husband to be the husband. Life can flow. Even though when the woman at times what makes the man rebellious at times is because when a woman is providing, you start saying, this man is a good for nothing. What can you do?
Yeah.
You don't have anything. What can you say? Call the children and tell them, oh, like that, you have a father has nothing. It's me doing this, it's
That's
me doing that.
Point. Calling the children, letting the children kind of exposing your husband's situation,
when you understand
your husband's weakness.
When you expose him, he rebels. Rebellion leads to conflicts. And when there are conflicts, that's how the family of the husband will be saying, oh, this woman want to kill her child. The family of the woman will be saying, oh, you see, it's like that. He's eating all her daughter's money and all the like. Meanwhile, you have to understand. In your own family, you have to sit down, talk together, and nothing is more than dialogue, my daughter.
Yeah, definitely. Nothing surpasses dialogue.
Nothing is more than dialogue. When you sit down and dialogue, and let me tell you that there is something. A woman, the Bible says, what does it say? A wise woman builds her home with her hands, and a foolish woman scatters
her home with her hands. Definitely. Some women are really kind of wise enough to build their homes with their hands, with their heads, and with their hearts.
Yes.
To make their family grow.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't expose their men to the outside world.
Yes.
In spite of his weakness, in
Yes.
spite of his incapability to provide for the family.
Mm-hmm.
But some women, on the other hand, are very good at exposing their husband. Like, I am the one providing. What is this man doing for me?
A
you see,
good for nothing man.
Yes, a good for nothing man. Those are some of the tax the men get.
Mm-hmm.
You see a situation where a woman is the one providing because she thinks she is providing. She can go out of the house and come back just at any time. The man is not supposed to say anything.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure her answer will be, I went out to look for money. In
mm-hmm.
cases like that, what kind of effect does it also have on the children at home? A woman, she decides to go out at any time and come back at any time because
Please.
Her excuse would be she's fending, she's looking for what the family is going to feed on.
The effect is negative. The woman is supposed to be submissive. That's what the Bible has said. And we have to be submissive. Be it what, you will not take, you will never change. Somebody just said, the father is the head and the mother is the heart. You will not take the heart and put it in the place of the head
yeah.
and you feel that it will function.
It can
never
function the same way.
It will never go. So you just need to be submissive under the husband. Then by the time when the woman starts growing wings, that's where conflicts start coming in. And the man starts violence. When you come late, he beats.
He beats.
Yes.
And then because you will come with the excuse that after all, you don't have to say anything. I'm working my head out there in order
mm-hmm.
to get for what we eat. You sit here.
When he beats,
nothing.
He seizes the money from you.
And he uses it uselessly.
He goes out, he gets drunk, he comes back, everybody who talks, he beats. Violence starts.
Because of your disrespect.
Because of
so
your disrespect.
So it boils down to the fact that, in spite of the fact that a woman big is the breadwinner of the family, she still has to pull down her wings, that she has to calm down, because a man still has his place. Every man, they say, has his ego, and it's not easy to kill the ego of a man, even with money. So even when you're providing for the family, you will not kill a man's pride with money.
Never.
But then it also doesn't stop our women from providing for the family. It brings me to another point, Ma. I'll now get to the main. I've talked a little bit about women a lot. let me come now to the main. The main, like we earlier said, they find it difficult to appreciate the fact that the woman is the one providing for a family. You will see a woman who really works she works 6 to 6 and comes back home just to make sure that she covers the expenses of the home, even though her husband cannot make it. But her husband is not there to appreciate. Some men, on the contrary, would instead use the money, they will use it in a way they will squander it, because after all, they don't want to really understand the pain the woman goes through. At times, I want to think that it's because the men are going through some sort of trauma of the fact that they cannot provide, and some men just naturally don't want to accept the fact that the women can contribute for the family. So at that point where the man is not ready to accept the fact that you're contributing, is it the place of a woman to, in order to avoid problems, also fold her arms and sit down? What can a woman do at that point in time?
It's difficult for a woman if a woman can really fold her hands and stay. You are the heart of the family, because you are taking care of the children, you are taking care of the man, you make sure that your house looks good. Everything is you.
And aside from that, you make sure that you go out and walk your head out
and
to bring
your head
back
out.
Something home.
All what I can say in this situation is this: before anything goes wrong, there must have been something that prompted it to go wrong. You, the woman, what do you have to do? You know when you can better talk to your husband and he hears you. That 4 o'clock in the morning, you tap him, daddy, look, it's like this. You talk to him. You talk and talk and talk. Even if he was sleepy, even if he was drunk,
he will hear
something. You will get something out of what you are saying. Maybe if you say, if you keep on doing like that, how would these children go? How would this? You will talk with him, you talk by it. At that time, even if it's in everything must have gone off, then you talk with him. Talk gently, with a gentle voice.
Manners of approach also matter.
Daddy, as you see, you are still that man that I loved the first day I saw you.
Even though you don't have a job.
But I still appreciate you. But all what I want from you is just that moral support. Just support me. As you support me, things will move.
One day you will have. That should be in the back of the minds of every woman. So understand that even though they are the breadwinners of the family, her husband still remains the head of the family, and they're the heart,
like Madame Mary,
just earlier said. They remain, and all what the women need is support from these men. Instances where maybe the man is not ready to let down his ego to accept the fact that the woman is the one providing. All the woman needs now is support from them. And then let's come now to the effect of this provision by women on children. You will see that the family has male children also, and then the children grow up, and maybe due to some women, they cannot take the fact that the woman is the one providing, or they are the ones providing. At some point in time, they lose it, and then they tend to talk so much about it that it falls the children get to hear about it. These children grow knowing under the notion that it's very normal for a woman to provide for their families. These male children will have the tendency tomorrow to be very okay with the fact that they can grow without doing anything besides, my mama provided for our home, my wife can also provide. Do you see it in that way, that in homes where the woman is the breadwinner, male children of those homes tend to grow, and they have tendency of growing and not getting worried about providing for their homes because they have been used to their mother providing? Do you see any kind of tendency, any situation where that could happen in the nearest future?
It could happen, but you as a woman, I think when we talk of the heart of the family, the heart is where the blood flows to every part of the body, the functioning of the body, because if without the heart, there's no life. So if you, the woman, can train your child the way he should go, when the child is up, you will not regret it.
Okay.
When you train your child the way he should go, when he gets big, you will continue in that training, the way you train. If you say, even though this is happening, I'm sorry that people will have seen, but it's not good like this. But it's always good. For the ideal home, what do you do? When there's a partner, when the man is not providing, you propose to budget, you sit down, you do your budgeting together, you discuss everything of yours in your room. When you get out, maybe it's money they're supposed to give to the child. The father will take you, say, thank you, daddy. The child doesn't know who has given that money.
Thank you very much for that point. Thank you. I was really thinking about that. Thank you. You brought it up that the woman and the man, the woman should have the humility of kind of communicating with her husband, bringing him down.
Mm-hmm.
They arrange everything and budget everything in their room to make sure that prove to the world that your man is the one providing.
Yes.
Let him have that place. Let him have his place.
The place of the man as the head of the family.
In spite of the fact that you are the one providing, so that it also not pass a bad message on the children, it also not pass a negative effect on the children, and then they get to grow in that situation where they would think that with the man providing is very normal, with our mother providing is very normal.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to say it again. What should the woman do?
I was just saying that the woman has to be submissive.
Mm-hmm.
Submissiveness is what counts. When you are submissive, and what a woman needs from a man is just the love. If you have the love, you can go extra miles. Just come by and say, "Dear, I love you."
So that one goes to the men. At that point in time, the men have to also show their women love and support.
Yes.
It's not easy for a woman to be the one to show that all the expenses of the home, because it's not only her home should be taken care of at that point in time. I believe that the husband's family also have needs.
Yes.
And at some point, it's the woman who is going to kind of show that the needs of the husband's family, and her own family is also on the other side putting pressure on her for her to provide. But the key point is, in spite of every fact that she is the one providing, she should let her man have his place. She shouldn't show to the world that her man is living under her wings. She should leave him his space. It's on that very beautiful note that we're going to take a musical break now to join DJ Van and Tyrone as they sing Hashtag Woman. We'll be right back.
Your button better. Shake it, African sweetie, move your button.
That was Tyrene singing Women for Us. She's portraying the hard work of a woman. She's portraying the power of an African woman. And that's what we're talking about today. Traditionally, the man is known to be the provider of the family. But times have changed. Everything is turning around. And the women find themselves nowadays being at that point in time, being in a situation where they're the ones providing for the family. But when this comes to pass, when the woman is the breadwinner of the family, what's at stake? Many people believe that it causes a shake in the family, because a woman, when she provides, she tends to be dominant, she tends to be proud, and she tends to be a little bit kind of authoritative when it comes to her husband. Some believe that it's all about communication and dialogue for a family to be in good condition, for a family to be stable, even if the woman is the one providing. That's why our guest on the program today, Madame Queen de Marie, Madame Queen de Mary, I love to call her Marie, tells us that in spite of the fact that the woman is the sole provider, she ought to remain submissive. And talking about submission here, we're talking about letting the man having his place. It brings us to another part, to the second part of the program, ladies and gentlemen, still with Madame Marie. Madame Marie, do you believe in the fact that an African woman is powerful and hardworking?
Yes, of course. Yes, of course, an African woman is powerful
and hardworking.
An African woman
doesn't mind providing for her family.
We don't mind.
She supports her husband. She wants to give her husband a helping hand.
Yeah.
Like, an African woman also believes in the fact that my husband had it before. If he doesn't have it today, it is my time to kind of grab the bull by the horns and also provide for the family.
Yeah.
But nowadays it's causing a little bit of shake in the family. That's what I've noticed. I want to find out from you, maybe you've had family members, friends, or women, or maybe from kind of external experiences, what have people really shared with you with regards to the fact that women provide for the family? What have really been the outcome of that?
I shared with women and told me, she said, I provide, but I don't feel the pain of providing. I go to the farm, I work, I come back, I sell. If my husband doesn't have, I give. But all what I need to him is just an appreciation. I need him to appreciate me, just to say I love you. That is just what I want from him. So when I shared, another one told me, when a woman gets married, all she looks after, when things start going a time, the woman is always there to work but the husbands at times start violence, they will start saying, you want to show that you have money, you are doing this because of this or that. I say no. So in most cases, the women, due to the love of their children in the home, they will not like to leave that home and go. So they are always there, patient for everything. So they are always praying. When you see, most women go to church, but men just relax.
And that's another part of provision. They provide also spiritually.
Spiritually.
They say the woman is the backbone of every family. It's the woman that keeps the family alive.
Yeah.
It's the woman that prays. She also provides kind of spiritual attention of the family. She gives the spiritual needs of the family. You have brought me to another point.
When there's a problem, she will cry to God to say, God help me, please, I don't know what to do. Oh, she will pray and pray and pray. When the problems maybe are over, she will say, oh, God help me for this. The man will just take it for granted.
The man will really take it for granted. So that kind of shows us the fact that the woman doesn't only work out day all through the day to provide for the family, but at night a woman also doesn't sleep. She prays ceaselessly to make sure that her provision, should have an impact on the family.
Mm-hmm.
And then I also want to believe that when a woman is providing for the family, it's natural that at times you wouldn't want to be dominant, you wouldn't want to be authoritative or disrespectful.
Yeah.
But the devil has his way of coming in.
Mm-hmm.
So after working all through the day, after working your head out all through the day to provide for your family, you also ought to have a cool head at night to pray to God to guide you, to be humble even in your kind of ability to provide for the family.
Yeah.
You ask for humility in your riches.
Yes.
Because a woman who is providing for the family but does not have the Spirit of God, or kind of the humility that it entails, is definitely going to rather cause the family to fall rather than making it to stand.
It's true.
Yeah. So a woman also provides for the family spiritually. And now the question that comes to my mind is, you mentioned that some women enjoy providing for their families. I want to come a little bit personal, Madame Pandey Mary. Have you ever found yourself in a situation all through your marriage life where your husband was a little bit financially down and you were the one to shoulder all the expenses of your family?
Yes, of course. Yes.
What were the challenges?
The challenges were there. Most of the challenges were, I will provide. When I provide, I'm telling this what we're going to do, this what we are going to do. So even the school fees, the children's school fees, if he does not have, I'll say this what I've struggled, I've been able to have, take this and pay the children's school fees. So that's how we're moving and things were going.
Okay.
But the only problem usually is that being human, at times you make certain errors, but if you are prayerful, you pray God to put you on the route so that you will be moving well, you're going so that you will not hurt the man, allow him his place. Because what is worse is to take the man's place in the house. When you take the man's place, that's where violence comes. A man will never allow his place to be taken. He is the head, he remains the head.
He is the head and he remains the head. That's why they also, some people also believe that when a woman is providing solely for the family, it causes some insecurity on the side of the men. The men will start feeling insecure, like they start feeling like at any time this woman can leave me. It also causes some men kind of fall depressed because of the situation at hand, like the woman is the one providing, and in the course of their feeling insecure, they tend to do things that the woman will not appreciate enough. I want to find out from you, why, how do men generally, have you ever had the experience of how, why is it that the men really feel insecure? Is it the fact, is it now a problem of trust? Because I believe that if couple are really in love and they trust each other so much and they are understanding and there's dialogue and communication in the home, a woman providing for the family would necessarily not cause the man to feel insecure.
It would be a problem.
But naturally the men feel insecure at times and feel like this one that she's providing already, she's already proving herself to be the man, even though the woman are doing it as a means of supporting.
She's not doing it as a means of supporting.
Yes.
But the man will always in his subconscious will just say, I don't know what this woman has in the back of her head. Maybe she's feeling a type, feeling that she might go and all the like. But meanwhile, the woman doing it, she's doing it voluntarily. She knows that this is my home and I have to do it. So at times, some men will have some problems, as like just as you were saying, stress up that this woman, she wants to show that she is this. But if you go down, if you are submissive, you're going to explain it to him quietly. I think things will go rightly. But if you, the woman, want to show that, what do you want to say? Am I not the one doing this? That's why.
That's
you'll
why
be receiving some beatings every day.
You're receiving some beatings, that's where domestic violence comes in.
Yes.
Because the man would never want a woman to take his place. And then there are also some women who provide for their family and then they kind of, apart from the children, apart from showing it to the children that they're providing for their family, they're solely providing for the family, their family, that's the woman's relatives who also know. And then this plays a lot on the man. I can assure you that the worst disgrace a man will ever have is for his in-law to look down on him.
It's true.
Yeah, it's for his in-law to look down on him. So at that point in time, how can a woman really handle not exposing her family or her husband to her relatives due to the kind of repercussion it will have on her marriage?
You just have to avoid saying things. I don't know. You don't speak anyhow. Because you have a problem, you go telling your mother, your father, this what may you relate everything in your home. No, it's not like that. You go back to your room, call him to order. When there's a problem, you say, Daddy, this what I think. I think if this were like this, it would have been moving well. You don't go out disgracing him, say, as you see him like that, it's me who's doing this. As you see him, when you do like that, the man will go crazy. When this, the worst thing for a man is to have inferiority complex. When a man has complex, he can abandon you then, go look for somebody and stay with you. I can just abandon you. I don't know. The worst thing for a man is to have a complex. So you just avoid, you just have to be managing him. You say, no, it's not like that. Let's see. Let's try to come together and see what we can do. Please, this little thing that I have, I don't know whether you can do something with this. Just the morals, just him up.
Yeah, in morals, with good morals. But there are also situations where at times the woman will have no choice than to open up to her family, because we understand that this is Africa, and even when we're married, our own homes are not forgotten. We still provide for our families back at home, because a woman got married to a man doesn't mean she should abandon her own family.
Yeah.
And then the family now expects a lot from the woman. Maybe when your husband was still providing for the family, you had the possibility, you had the chance, you had the means of providing for your own family. Maybe you were paying school fees for your junior ones. Maybe you were sending your mother a little bit of something back at home. But now, because you're kind of shouldering all the expenses of your home, you are no longer sending that money back home. And then you necessarily do not want to expose your husband, but with the pressure from the family, you just have to open up to them. Is that not a situation where maybe you have to open up to your own family to say, it's like that, I'm the one providing for my own family now because my husband lost his job because of this. We should just understand each other that at this point in time, I will not be able to give what I used to give before because I am giving this amount in the house. Maybe that's a case where a woman will be forced to open up to her family. What do you think?
Yeah, a woman will be forced to open up to her family positively or negatively. The opening up is positively. We are just telling the situation what is happening. Please, I won't be able to do this. My brother, if you can fill that gap, because I'm down now, then they will understand me. It will not be like a mockery.
So it only matters,
it's the way you are presenting the problem that matters. Present it in a gentleman. Just take for example, if your child is here, you say, please, get up from that place and bring me the thing. Say, get up from there.
Because it's problem.
So it matters the way you present it. The presentation matters now. When you present it in a cold way, I think he himself, even your people will not come to say, no, it's her daughter doing this. They will even sympathize that way. This man who used to do this for us, now he's not doing because he does not
have. But there are some in-laws that are really ungrateful. They can never understand the fact that at some point in time, a man also lacks, a man also goes down, a man goes bankrupt, and he doesn't have anything. And then they always tend to expect. That's when the man feels like, what do I do? This woman's family is taking over my home just because I have nothing to offer. I don't feel man enough and stuff like that. But then at that point in time when a man feels that way, it's still the woman's place to give him reassurance, right? Still the woman's place.
Yeah, Elia said, a wise woman builds her home with her hands, and a foolish woman scatters the home. You, the woman, you just have to be wise. You know how the way you play, just the way you play your game. Yes, at this point, at times you even ask for God for discernment. Say, God, I'm now hooked in this place. What do I do? God will tell you what to do. The way forward. You depend on God. Since you are also spiritual, you provide, even the provision is spiritual. You say, Lord, what do I do? The Lord will show you. There are times that when you feel the road has ended here, that's when the Lord is opening.
You ask God for discernment.
Yes.
Okay. Now it brings me to a point you mentioned. I didn't want to kind of go deep into it. You talked about a woman who kind of gives her man the possibility, gives her man the chance. Like, you walk and then you come back, you're like, honey, this is what I worked for today.
Yeah.
Have it. Let's see how we're going to kind of budget for the month. Let's see how we're going to do. But then it causes a problem. There are some men who take that like an insult. Like, what do you want to show that you're the one providing and stuff like that? A woman really finds it difficult handling that kind of a thing. Don't you think that at times it also depends on the kind of man that you have?
It depends on the kind of man. I think from the beginning I mentioned that there are families that are built on a solid rock. Another family that is not built that is not on a solid rock, a family that is built on a solid rock, what do they do? Know that, yes, we live, the Bible says we should leave your parents, man, we should leave and cleave to his word. When you're talking of cleaving, that it means that they are becoming one, one person. When you are one person, you are, no, they cannot separate. You are together. When you are Christians, you come together, you pray together. When you go out, maybe you go as you have your big a salary, you come and say, honey, this is what I have. You pray over it. They say, what do you think you can do? See, dear, don't you know that if we, this as we budgeted, we said, by this time, this is what we have to do. By at this time, this is what we have to do. You budget the money, you know that this one is going for my mother, this one is going to your mother, this one is... You are now one person, man. You are not two, as a songwriter would rightly say, one plus one, is one. Mm-hmm. You are now one person. Then you say, honey, look, what do we do? You say, okay, we have to budget, we have to keep the children's profits, you keep. We have to do this, we do. We have to do this. When you budget all that, okay, this is your pocket allowance, this is my money. Move together. Nobody knows whether the man. By then, you are not praying. God, provide something for my
husband.
When you pray, God will do it. Because the Bible says if you ask,
he will give. If a woman should pray for God to provide a job for her husband, because there are some women who will get carried away by the power they have when they are providing, and then they will forget that they have to pray for their husbands to get back their positions as the sole provider of the family. Mm-hmm. And then there are also cases where the man, when you're a woman, is really trying hard, going out there, working so hard to come back in order to support her husband in times that he is lacking. Mm-hmm. The man does not believe that the woman went to work. There were men like that. They wouldn't believe that you went out to work. Like, they always feel that you went somewhere else. Your destination was not work. Your destination was somewhere else. It's difficult for a woman to also handle that kind of situation. That's why at times a woman will just decide to do anything, because after all, he doesn't believe in me. What's the purpose of me continuing to provide when, if I'm going out to work, he has one or two complaints to lay? Don't you think the men also have a part to play as far as trust is concerned? When they don't have anything to provide, they also have to be humble enough to accept the fact that the woman is working hard to provide.
Yeah. When they don't have anything, I earlier told you that there is one thing that God wants from you, is to love the wife as Christ loved the church and died. The church. Christ died. You should love, the man should be able to love the wife in a way that he can die for that woman. So, loving the wife the way you can die for the woman is trusting her. You need to trust her. This is my woman. I know her. I know everything of her. Everywhere she is going, I know she is here. For example, I'm here. If you ask my husband, where is your wife? She'll say, even though I'm a mother, she'll say she's at the radio. I told him. He's the one
who... At the TV.
At the TV. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Okay. Make your husband to trust you. Be honest. Tell him where you are going and you are there.
And he should know the nature of your job. Because
he should know.
There are some women with jobs that are not really defined. It's not every woman has the opportunity to say, I'm a banker or I'm a teacher. Your husband will know that you're teaching.
For example, I'm a nurse.
Yes.
I go for night duties. Mm-hmm. That time there's a problem in the house, he'll come and meet me there. But if he comes and you are not there, it's a problem.
He should know where you are.
He should know where you are. And when he goes like that and he sees that, yes, when I'm looking for her, I know she's here. If she's not in the church, she's at work. If she's not at work, she's at home. That's the trust. Make your man to trust you.
So that when you are working hard to provide, there wouldn't be any problem.
There wouldn't be any problem.
Make your man to trust you is on that note that we get out of set and get into the world of fashion, not forgetting that today we're talking handbags. A woman that provides for the family also has the tendency of providing for herself. A woman loves fashion, and when you're providing for the family, don't forget you have to provide for yourself. Let's see what the markets have for us today as far as bags are concerned.
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. cannot talk of fashion in a woman nowadays without making mention of her choice of handbag. A woman's handbag, they say, is an embodiment of her total self. On her fashion page today, we will be looking at the various kinds and brands of handbags our everyday women love to be identified with. Ranging from leather to the just easy-to-go handbags, a variety of them exist in the market at different prices, different sizes, and different colors. A woman today, in order to stay fashionable, could pick a handbag, either the classy one or the everyday handbag, from the local market. In spite of its multiple existence in the market, women still have their preferences today. While some go for the very chic and fashionable ones, others will prefer the simple ones that can get them to just anywhere, any day, at any time. Women nowadays have lots to say as far as the trend in handbag is concerned. Some cannot do without it, while some can really do without it. Whether they are handbags, shoulder bags, purses or clutches, every woman would love to use these to stay fashionable and chic always. Talking of fashion in women, talk of handbags.
Welcome back from the world of fashion. That was her fashion page for you, and today we were talking handbags. As the woman provides for her family, as I earlier said, she also has the tendency to provide for herself. Mama Marie, I want to find out from you, that point where a woman is providing for her family, we kind of notice that a woman neglects her own self because she's so consumed into this notion that my family is down, my man is down, I have to provide. She forgets to take care of herself. Don't you think that even as a breadwinner, a woman has the right to take care of herself physically? Like, we just saw the sort of handbag, she could get herself a beautiful piece of handbag, she could get this, but the man will also come in and be like, we don't have food to eat and you're taking your money to buy handbags and this and this and that. Don't you think a woman shouldn't forget herself in spite of the fact that there is the home?
Normally a woman shouldn't forget herself. Take example for myself, I make handbags, beads. Wow. Beads and making handbags. Mm-hmm. When I'm way out, I'll go one, then please not. I can sell, I can use some using beads. I think a woman should not neglect herself. That's why when you see this woman of Proverbs 31, I admire that woman so much.
Oh my God.
She will make this, she will go out, she will look this for the home. She's always very busy.
And God always blesses the works of her hands because
yes.
He believes that she is working hard for
her
home.
For her home.
And in the course of that, she doesn't forget herself. She makes sure that she also looks beautiful for
her
husband.
Good. She looks good for the husband.
Okay. That's why we have a fashion page, because every woman is supposed to look good in spite of everything they are going through in life. We were talking about trust. A man trusting his wife and not feeling insecure each time the woman is going out to work so hard to come back and provide the home. But there are also some women who kind of take advantage of the fact that they are the ones providing. They go out to make bad friends, and the bad friends they have influences the state of their marriage, because they will tend to tell these friends, I am the one providing for my home, my husband doesn't do this. We talked about relatives, we talked about children. Now let's talk about the woman's friends, the impact that this information from home that is supposed to be kind of confidential goes outside to the friends. What impact does it have on the husband? Is it comes down to make him feel kind of insecure or give him some inferiority complex?
Really, it gives him inferiority complex, because you, as a woman, I earlier said that no two homes are the same. No two homes are the same. That the homes You are a man, any person has the way he functions in his own home. So when you have a problem in your home, you don't go to go out there telling your friends. Be a spirit-filled woman so that by the time there's a problem, tell it to God. You don't go to tell it to your friends. You just say, oh, my friends, I'm the one providing. The friend will say, oh, for me, this is what I do. I go out and bring in all the life. Those are bad companies which will destroy your home. And when it destroys your home, you will end up regretting. And your friends will laugh at you. There are some friends who will come in. What they are saying, they are just saying, it's just lies. But to spoil your home. Maybe it's somebody who was admiring your home.
Yeah, to be.
Yes.
To have your kind of home.
Your kind of home. Then they want to just tell lies. Then when they tell the lies, it will affect your home. Then you will be like, where am I? So you don't need to make any kind of friends.
Because your friends will have impact on your husband. And then also your husband's friends are not supposed to know the state of your husband. They're not supposed to be aware of the fact that because he also has this reputation to retain as far as his societal life, his social life is concerned.
Yes.
It brings us also down to the fact that a woman who is the breadwinner of the family has to be courageous. I think it entails a lot of courage, Mama. It doesn't, you don't just get up one day and then you're providing for the family as a woman. It entails courage. What are some of the kind of virtues that a providing woman or a breadwinning woman should have apart from courage?
You need to be brave.
You need to be brave.
You need to talk less. Don't talk so much. Because the things you have taking yourself, you study. If you want to talk, don't make too much friends, because when you have too much friends, that's when you are going astray. You need that courage, you need to be brave. You say, yes, I know that this is a challenge that I'm taking, I'm passing through, and it will be through. God will see me through. As you are taking that challenge, God will help you to go through that challenge.
The woman needs to be brave. Apart from being courageous, she also needs to be brave. But there are some women who aren't brave enough to kind of brave the odds of being the ones providing for the family.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't work well for them. At some point, they can't show that. If I want to think that, they say money is not the focal point of every union.
It's true.
Yeah, it's not the main reason.
It's not
the motive of every union.
Yes, I think
that money has a very big role to play. Because there are some women who cannot take the fact, they cannot stomach the fact that their husband aren't doing anything. Do you buy the idea that for some women to provide, they prefer to divorce?
There are some women who quit. Some women will say, it depends the motive of your marriage. If the motive was, I saw him in Prado, he was going, I would like him, he used to give me money and all the like. Maybe at that point, you say, no, I can't bear it. But if the motive was love, when people are getting married, they say, whether it's good or bad, you remain together. When it's worst, you don't have to leave another person. You remain together until death do you part. So you have to be together until you don't have to say no, because now he's down, I have to leave him. I will leave him and go. I will do this, I will do that.
You don't have to go, but that's why it's also good for a woman to always have something to do while in her home. Because let's take a situation where maybe the man was a sole provider before, and the woman just had the domestic duty of a wife. She just had to take care of the children, cook at home, and the husband comes back. When now the man cannot do it, and then the woman had nothing to do, it causes a problem.
A big problem.
So a woman is supposed to always make sure that she does something.
It's good for a woman to do something.
Okay.
It's good for a woman to always have something doing. If you don't have an office job that you leave and go, why not do something and sell? Or why not? Even people are making just this Omo and selling. You just try to do something that you can be selling
occupy
that will keep
yourself.
You going. Occupy yourself.
And keep your
as I was like
going.
I was saying, making beads, handbags, all those things you sell, you occupy yourself.
And when your husband is lacking, you support
him.
And if he's completely down, you take over as a woman.
Yes.
I believe African women are powerful. They know how to take over. Though it's just this time around that it's getting kind of inculcated into the African culture that a woman will stand up to be the sole provider of the family. At first, we used to believe that traditionally it's the place of the man to go out and find something and come back home and feed the family. But nowadays, a woman has to do something. But in the course of doing something, in the course of providing for their homes, humility and submissiveness still have to be key points in every marriage.
Really?
Because a woman is the provider, she doesn't have to make her husband feel secured. Because she is the sole provider, she doesn't have to look down on her husband.
Yes.
She doesn't have to take advantage of the fact that she's providing
she's
for her
providing.
Family to play games on her husband.
True.
She doesn't have to sell her husband out to the entire world to make them know that I am the breadwinner of the family and my husband has nothing to do. Now let's take the case of a woman as the breadwinner, the effect on children now as a whole, the upbringing of children, the upbringing of children. A woman traditionally is known to be the one to have the best way of taking care of children.
Yes.
Situations now where the woman is the sole provider, like the man has nothing to do and the woman has to be out from 6 to 6 to provide for the family. What impact on the children? They're there with the man. We believe that the man really doesn't have this special attention for the woman. Don't you think it also causes a little bit of shake there?
It's a problem. When the woman is out 6 to 6, that's where the problem lies, because normally she does not even have time to take care of her home. She does not even know her children, because you send them to school. When they come, you don't even know what they are doing. Because normally when the child goes to school, if you are going to work, even if you are a teacher, you go and come back and take care of the children in the evening. But if you are that type that just goes and goes, and you don't come back, you leave the children with your babysitter. Before you know, the children will not even be the way you wanted them to be.
But you're doing that because you have to work and provide for the family. Those are some of the challenges the women face.
Yes, those are the challenges the women face. You are doing that because you have to work and provide for the family. But in that case, you have to be very sure to look for a nanny who will really take care, who will take instructions. When you say do this, she does it. Then when you come, you supervise.
Yeah, and kind of getting a nanny again is another expense for the home. A home that a father is not working, getting a nanny is another expense. But as we earlier said, if this woman is spiritually fit and she prays to God, despite or in spite of the fact that she leaves her home every day and she doesn't know the state of her children in her absence, she comes back. If she's prayerful, God will always cover her children. God will always cover her home.
God is always there to cover her home.
Yeah, because she's outside there.
She's
braving the odds of the outside world in order to provide for the family. It's on that note that we'll have to leave you for today's edition of All About Her. And we were talking about the woman being the breadwinner of the family. But before we leave, madam, I want you to say one word to the women who are breadwinning in their families, who are the breadwinners, and one word for the men who have lost their jobs or who have nothing doing and they are depending on their wives.
What I have to say here is that us, the women, we should be a good thing to the man, because the Bible says when the woman was created, the man looked at her and said, it's a good thing. We have to be good women. So as we are good, that's how the man will be comfortable. Because if you are a bad woman, you'll be like a cancer in the bone. We know we cannot treat cancer. So when you're a cancer in the bone for the man, you cannot treat it. The man will just depreciate and finish.
In spite of your power, your financial status,
you have to be a good woman. Being good is that you have to be submissive to the man. Take their place in your home. Be submissive and let the man be loving. You see your home flow.
Okay, then what about the man who sits down and he has no job and he's waiting only for his wife to provide for him? What do you advise that man to do? Because you, as a woman who has been in that position where she was the one providing for the home at some point in time, what did you expect from your husband? So that's what you expect from other men.
What I expect is that a man will not just sit and say. Even the Bible says there's no food for a lazy man. So, even if you have to go out there, do just achaba to give, just to contribute for the home, it's good that you go out. Because staying back only at home, that's how it will make you to be rebellious. You will only be seeing the negatives on the woman. Meanwhile, she's trying her best to keep the home going.
Definitely. Mm-hmm. He has to still fend. He has to struggle to put his hands at work and provide for the family. Ladies and gentlemen, that was it for today. But as a reminder, the perfect woman is that woman who doesn't just have a fine face, but she uses her head, she uses her heart, and she uses her brains to work for her family and to work for others. But in the course of providing for her family, woman, make sure that you're submissive to your husband, make sure that your family is at ease, and make sure that you are still the breadwinner and you're still that submissive wife. Madam Marie,
yes,
I want to thank
daughter.
You very much for keeping it a date with us today.
Okay, thank you also.
Hope to see you again in another edition.
Okay.
It's been a pleasure.
Okay.
Maybe say goodbye to
thank
the viewers.
You. Okay. Bye-bye.
Goodbye, everybody. See you again next week for another edition of All About Her.